God is restoring all that you have lost today in the name of Jesus. I have come to tell you that God wants to restore unto you whatever it is that you have lost. No matter what it is, He is willing to restore all of it. If I were to ask you if you had lost anything, the answer would most likely be yes. Most of us have lost things due to our ignorance, due to our disobedience, or stubbornness, due to our inability to hear God, our insensitivity to His leading. Take a look at the fact that the Israelites spent 40 years on their way to the promised land when they were only supposed to spend just a few days. Because of their rebellion and their inability to listen to God, what should have only taken less than 2 months ended up taking more than 40 years. Sometimes we are rebellious like the Israelites were. Other times we just miss out on the move of God because we are not prepared for it, or we are not sensitive enough to know when He is leading us in a particular direction. Think about all the times when God may have dropped an idea in your heart of what you needed to do to address a certain situation in your life, and how you missed out on it because you either forgot it or didn't pay attention enough to it to even think that it was important. Over and over again, you find God having serious life-challenging encounters with His children in dreams and visions. With Joseph, the vision of his future. With Solomon, the blank check He gave him to ask for whatever he desired. All this took place in dreams. How many dreams, my friend, have you had that could have completely changed your life, but you just didn't remember? God is restoring every single one of them in this season, in Jesus' name. Sometimes you allow sin to dwell in your life and give the devil a foothold in your life. You give him the opportunity to take advantage and rob you of the blessings that God has set aside for you. You allow him to take away from you the things that God has rightfully said are yours. Because you have a guilty conscience, you buy into the lies that he tells you of how you cannot expect to receive the blessings of God in your life. And you lose what is rightfully yours in the first place. You have repented, but still the devil continues to haunt you with thoughts of what you've lost and how it's all your fault and you will never get it back. Today, God is bringing His word to you to tell you that He Himself is restoring you. Whatever you may have lost as a result of sin or disobedience or rebellion or even impatience, your God is the God of perfect replacement. He is giving you double for your trouble in this season, in Jesus' name. Whatever the enemy had tried to take away from you, God wants to restore it. God, my friend, wants to make it better than before. This is the kind of God you serve. Whether you lost it as a result of your own doing or the enemy stole it from you, God is ready, willing, and able to restore it to you today. It is not His desire that you miss out on anything that He has made available for you and has intended for you to have. God wants you to live a full life, to live in the abundance of all He has called you to do, be, and have. So, stay with me as I share with you some of the things that God desires to restore in your life today, even as He restores you also. The first thing is time. Time, my friend, is one of the most important commodities we have in life, because time is equal to life. In the understanding of the world, they believe that all things can be replaced except time. But your God says that He is more than capable of restoring even the time that you have lost. You, my friend, may be worried right now because you feel that some certain seasons have passed your way completely and that you will never get them back. Maybe you feel like the time has passed to pursue a new career, or that you have wasted all the opportunities God gave you to get married or to have kids, or for something you really desire. Do you feel like it is too late? If only you had known, you would have started serving God way earlier. If only you had known some of the things you knew now, you would have taught them to your children. Whatever your regret may be, my friend, whatever time you may have lost, whatever time the devil may have stolen from you, God Almighty is capable of restoring it to you even right now in the name of Jesus. How does God restore time to us? He does it in many ways. But one of the ways He specializes in doing it is by giving to us twofold in a very short time what we ought to have to wait a long time for. I once heard the story of a woman who was trusting God for children for around 10 years or more. And in the 10th year, God gave her triplets. What do you call that? A manifold blessing. She caught up with her mates in what seemed like an overnight experience. There is nothing that is impossible for your God to do. All you have to do is believe it to experience it. The Bible tells us in Joel, the 2nd chapter, the 25th verse, it says, I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm. God is restoring to you all the lost seasons of your life in the name of Jesus. You, my friend, may have spent them chasing the wrong things. You may have spent them serving the devil even, but I tell you that God has the ability to give you a double recompense, a double compensation. Don't focus on blaming yourself. Instead, focus on trusting that now that you have given your life to God, He is not interested in punishing you for your past. Rather, He is more interested in getting you to experience His love and His fullness and His abundance in your life. The second thing that God is going to be restoring in your life are opportunities. One of the things that hurt us the most when we lose them are opportunities. Sometimes God brings opportunities our way and we lose them because we are not prepared for them. We don't know how to handle them. Then the time comes when we know better and we look back on those missed opportunities with regret. We look back on those missed opportunities and wish we could turn back time. At other times, opportunities are stolen from us. We do all we are supposed to do and still miss out on them. The word of the Lord for you today is that God is restoring every opportunity you may have lost. It will not just come back, it will come back bigger and better. It may not be the exact same opportunity as what you lost, but what God is bringing your way will definitely be better. God is always up to date. Trust that His word is true and His promises are reliable, and begin to prepare for that new opportunity. Make sure you don't miss out on it again because you are not prepared enough. Stay prepared. The third thing God is going to be restoring in your life is strength. God wants to restore your strength. Perhaps you are struggling right now in a situation and it seems like your strength is failing. Like it is difficult to keep holding on. Like you can't go on any longer. He says that His strength is made perfect in your weakness. When you are weak is when He specializes in being strong. You may have been wondering how you are going to keep holding on. Keep having faith. Keep pressing. Keep being patient because it seems like you are about to exhaust your limits. God has a word for you today. In Isaiah, the 40th chapter, the 31st verse, He says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Whatever has made you weary is not important. Bring your weariness and your heaviness to God and see Him fill you with strength, not just to walk, but to run, and not just to run, but also to fly. Your God is the restoration specialist. There are many more areas where God wants to restore you. These are only a few of them. We will be covering some more in other videos, but God has come to remind you today, my friend, that He wants to satisfy the desires of your heart and restore all that you had lost. Take Him at His word and begin to receive testimonies like never before in the name of Jesus. May God continue to restore you in Jesus' name. God bless you.